The universe is a very strange place by its very nature. Mysterious questions abound over dark matter, dark energy, how it all came to be, and so on. But at the same time, as our astronomical instrumentation has improved, in modern times we have been able to study the universe in unprecedented detail. As that process has unfolded, the universe has rewarded us with both understanding, but also new mysteries, many of which have not been solved. In the course of making this channel, I have run across and covered many such astronomical mysteries, some of them now solved, some of them not, but there has always been a core group that offer possibilities so weird that they continue to baffle scientists to this day. So here are 10 unsettling astronomical incidents and phenomena. Number 10. The Nature of Pulsars. When pulsars were first discovered in the 1960s, the possibility that they were alien beacons had to be seriously considered, after it was shown that they were not a product of Earth interference. They were, after all, highly unnatural-looking pulses of electromagnetic radiation that repeated with such regularity that some of them rivaled the accuracy of atomic clocks. In the years since, we have learned that they are just an unusual case of nature emitting a regular signal by way of a rapidly rotating neutron star. This would seemingly lay the idea of alien involvement with pulsars to rest, except it actually doesn't. In 2017, Clement Vidal authored a paper that reopened the question of an alien technological origin for pulsars, or at least a certain class of them, that could have been natural objects tweaked by aliens for communications. He pointed out that there were five reasons that aliens were originally taken off the table as an explanation. The first was the truly titanic amounts of energy involved. It seemed unlikely to some that a civilization would use that kind of energy. Trouble is, we've never seen an alien civilization, and we really have no idea what they would be capable of energy-wise, and we do still talk about galaxy-spanning Kardashev Type 3 civilizations that would command far more energy than a pulsar. The other four reasons are equally problematic. One was that they are not unique. In other words, how likely would it be that two separate civilizations would broadcast the same way at similar frequencies? Well, our Earth civilizations do that, and SETI does spend a lot of time looking for aliens at the frequency of 1420 MHz because there are inherent scientific advantages to do so, that alien scientists would also know about. Perhaps that could be the case with pulsars. Another reason was that pulsars generally do not emanate from planetary systems, but who says aliens have to stick to a planet? Also, they are not narrowband, kicking out broadband transmissions wastes energy, and technology generally sticks to narrowband as a result. But if pulsars started out as natural objects that are being tweaked for communications by exocivilizations, then broadband may just be a natural leftover artifact. But the fifth argument is the most solid. We have perfectly good natural explanations for pulsars that fit the bill. There really isn't a reason or need to evoke aliens when something appears explained and natural, but that doesn't eliminate the pesky possibility that pulsars could be tweaked by an exocivilization as a natural carrier for communications, and that, maybe, we should look for that, especially in light that some of them are extremely accurate in their pulses to the point that they could be used for something like a navigational beacon. That near-absolute regularity present in some pulsars does look a bit odd, decades after they were first detected. Number 9. Fast radio bursts. This particular phenomenon is a relatively new one, having only been discovered in 2007. They come as very quick bursts of radio waves that arrive in such a way that scientists know that while extremely powerful, they must come from very small sources that are likely outside our galaxy, limiting what could be causing them. Further limiting what they might be is that at least one has been seen to repeat, seemingly ruling out any sort of cataclysmic event, such as a black hole merger. Most hypotheses currently on the table involve neutron stars or magnetars in some sort of odd situation, but it's also hypothetically possible that they could be of alien origin. In 2017, Manasvi Lingham and Abraham Loeb released a paper, link below, explaining that it's possible that the origin of at least some of them could be leakage from alien light sails, because the frequencies at which FRBs are detected happen to also be optimum frequencies for use with light sails. More, given that FRBs have been shown to originate from very small sources, they point out that the emitter for a light sail would need to be about twice the diameter of Earth, well within the constraints on what could be producing FRBs. Number 8. The Dyson Sphere Candidates. Sometimes, ideas within the realm of futurism can be so speculative that, if realized, are probably going to prove impractical. One such concept is the Dyson Sphere, though it should more accurately be called a Stapledon Sphere, after the sci-fi author that envisioned them in the 1930s, as opposed to Dyson's actual vision of a swarm of energy collectors. To actually encase a star within a solid shell would be a megastructure undertaking of truly titanic proportions that would involve things like completely disassembling planets for raw materials. And it's not entirely clear how such a thing would be engineered, constructed, and maintained. Surprisingly, however, out of all the hypothetical alien megastructures that we have yet envisioned, the Dyson Sphere remains the only one for which we have detected candidates, though they probably aren't very good ones and are likely really due to natural phenomena. The detections stem from a search of infrared data from the IRAS satellite done by scientists at Fermilab. The idea is that Dyson spheres absorbing energy from their star would re-emit that energy in the infrared in a specific, detectable way. They found 17 candidates that fit, though they were very ambiguous and probably have natural explanations, though efforts to figure out what they are ongoing. And another project to search for them using the Gaia spacecraft has already yielded a further two eyebrow raisers, TYC-7169-1532-1 and TYC-6111-1162-1. Though again, they are really ambiguous. Nothing definitive, but in coming years, if civilizations do indeed encase their stars in Dyson spheres, it seems likely we'll spot it. Number 7. The Phantom Planet. Unlike most of the phenomena on this list, this one could well be explained within the next few years, as several groups of scientists are actively looking for it. The motion of objects in the outer solar system is peculiar, as though they were disturbed by a large object lurking out in the outer solar system. In fact, yet another object showing orbital peculiarities consistent with this was found recently, bolstering the case that another planet exists in the solar system much further out than the orbit of Neptune. One possibility is that it's this solar system's missing super-Earth. Our solar system is unusual because we lack a super-Earth, seemingly one of the more common types of planets in the Milky Way. This hypothetical planet may have formed closer into the solar system, but might have been pushed out early in the solar system's history. Another possibility is that it may not be from this solar system at all, and may be a captured object the Sun acquired at some point in its history, in which case it would be a truly alien interloper in our solar system, and would offer us a chance at studying an actual former exoplanet that formed somewhere else. While it's not universally accepted that Planet 9 must be out there, there is also an argument that the data is skewed and it may not exist at all. Whatever the case, as hints of this phantom planet's existence continue to surface, it seems very possible that within a few years, we may well have another known planet to explore. Number 6. TYC-8241-2652. This entry is truly bizarre because not only is there no ready explanation for it having happened, but also there's no ready explanation for how fast it happened. In 1983, the star TYC-8241-2652 was observed in the infrared to have a debris disk. That in itself is nothing unusual. Dust disks are a normal part of planetary formation, and indeed Earth itself formed from one. And over time, a very long time in geologic terms, these disks tend to clear out as stable planetary systems develop. When TYC-8241-2652 was observed in 2010, the dust disk had completely disappeared, not in millions of years, but in the time since a previous observation in 2008. Whatever caused the dust disappearance did it in under 2 years. Numerous natural explanations were suggested for just how that could happen, only to fall flat. And the cause for the disappearance remains a mystery, and has been seen in no other star system with debris disks since. Number 5. 234 detections of something strange. Occasionally, a scientific paper will come out that's seemingly worthy of attention and then instantly goes into obscurity. That's essentially what happened with a paper by Hermano Borra and E. Trottier in 2016. It related to an earlier paper by Borra, where he predicted that certain types of pulses could be produced by current technology and be detected 1,000 light years away, and vice versa. Borra then searched existing data for anything that might look like those kinds of signals. He found 234 of them. Now, the media at the time sensationalized the story, and in some cases badly reported it, as though aliens had been found. This was not the case, and the scientists themselves made no claims that this was an actual detection of alien civilizations, merely that that was a possibility and that further follow-up work should be done. And that's where it sits today. But one thing still stands out. Nearly all of the detections were coming from stars of spectral types believed to be suitable for life. Number 4. The Wow Signal. This bizarre signal in some ways gets even more bizarre as time goes on, simply because an alien origin for it cannot be ruled out, even though the signal was detected over 4 decades ago. In 1977, astronomer Jerry Amon, using the Big Ear radio telescope at The Ohio State University, picked up a signal. This signal was noteworthy for several reasons. The first is that it was very close to 1420 MHz, which is the frequency at which hydrogen, the most common element in the universe, emits radio waves. This frequency is of note to SETI scientists. In fact, it's set aside and not broadcasted on specifically for this reason. Because any alien civilization that possesses science and radio transmitters would know of this frequency. As a result, it might be a universal frequency to broadcast a contact signal. The second is that the wow signal was strong, very strong, which is why Dr. Amon famously wrote wow on the printout. The third strange thing about the signal was that it was narrowband. Nature tends to emit radio signals broadband, whereas technology tends towards narrowband. Another odd aspect of the wow signal is the fact that it was a very brief signal, in that it was there, then it was not. That seems counterintuitive for a contact signal, and it's never been picked up since, despite plenty of attempts to do so. Perhaps the strangest aspect of wow, though, is that it keeps defying explanation. It's never been shown to have been Earth interference, or a glitch in the equipment that picked it up. To this day, potential explanations continue to be put on the table, only to be shot down. This happened most recently with the hypothesis that wow might have been due to emissions originating from comets, and this was widely reported in the press as a case-closed explanation. What they didn't report as widely is that the comet hypothesis was shot down by the scientific community very quickly. If comets emitted that strongly at the hydrogen line, radio astronomers would have noticed that by now, and it should be easily observable. It's not. So to this day, the wow signal remains unexplained. Number 3. Strange Signals. While the wow signal is the most famous of the unexplained odd radio signals SETI astronomers have picked up, it is not unique. Other examples include a signal picked up just once and did not repeat from the direction of the star TYC1220-91-1. What's notable about the signal is that it appeared to originate from a nearby star that's very similar to our Sun and potentially habitable. It was also at a magic frequency mathematically related to the 1420 MHz hydrogen line. It was also narrowband and was observed for a full 10 seconds. But most noteworthy was that the signal was so strong, about 10 times stronger than wow. But since that signal didn't repeat and couldn't be verified, it can't ever be determined if it was simply Earth interference. Other unverifiable signals include a 2015 signal from the star HD164595, another very sun-like star, but this time with a verified planet in orbit around it, but it never repeated, and it happened to be in a military band, and it seems likely that there are satellites downlinking from orbit that scientists may not be aware of. And then there was the signal SHGB02+14A, which was weird even for a signal plausibly of alien origin. Firstly, unlike most, this signal repeated, having initially been observed 3 different times, and it was at the 1420 MHz frequency, initially, but then it would drift. More, there didn't seem to be any corresponding star system to where the signal was coming from, and it was very weak, and if it originated on a planet, that planet would have to have been rotating 40 times faster than Earth. Number 2. KIC 8462852, Tabby's star. In 2015, a star was found in the massive amount of data collected by the Kepler spacecraft that was behaving like no other star previously seen. it would experience dips in brightness of up to 22%, suggesting that something extremely massive was passing in front of the star. Initially, it was uncertain as to what this could be. A cloud of dust wasn't a good fit because star systems that have dust disks tend to emit infrared radiation brightly. No such radiation was found at KIC 8462852. The star's main investigator, Dr. Tabitha Boyajian, suggested that it could be cold comets blocking the light. But on further investigation, it was found that the number of comets needed to produce the effect would have been implausible. More, another study found that exocomet signatures in the Kepler light curves don't fit what's going on at Tabby's star. Given that natural explanation after natural explanation were falling flat with the star, the idea that gigantic alien megastructures could be blocking the light was starting to be seriously considered. Now, even that doesn't fit, as later research showed that whatever was blocking the light, at least with the most recent dips measured from the ground here on Earth, was not opaque, and that dust in some sort of bizarre juxtaposition around the star had to be the cause. But there's still that question of the missing infrared. To date, no one knows exactly what's going on at KIC 8462852. Number 1. Jabilsky's Star. At the time when the KIC 8462852 story was a media hit, it was often called the strangest star in the universe. And while it certainly was strange, this final star on our list gives it a run for its money. This star is called Jabilsky's Star after the Polish-American astronomer that first studied it. The star is what's known as a peculiar star, a class of stars that are chemically unusual in some way when compared to other stars. But even then, this star stands apart because it contains elements that really shouldn't be there and are more at home in a laboratory on Earth than they are in nature. And it's not just a handful of odd elements, it's a lot of them, in sufficient quantities to be detectable at great distance in the star's spectrum. Elements like praseodymium, ytterbium, technetium, and promethium are present, the last only discovered through the activities of the Manhattan Project. Certainly odd, but stars can have odd elements in them. But there's more. The star is also anomalously low in iron and nickel, abundant elements in the universe. But perhaps strangest of all are the very short-lived actinide elements higher on the periodic table than uranium. Quite a few of these are present, and it's just weird, but one in particular raises an eyebrow, plutonium. Plutonium is thought to be produced only in minute quantities in nature, and only under specific circumstances. For this star to have it in abundance is a complete mystery, though hypotheses have been put forth that you might be able to get to elements higher than uranium if the star were bombarded by a neutron star, or some unknown nuclear process within the star is creating the elements. But it's worth mentioning that in 1966, Carl Sagan and Josef Shklovsky hypothesized in their book Intelligent Life in the Universe that one way for an alien civilization to announce its presence to others would be to add large amounts of plutonium to its star. Thanks for listening. I'm futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently planning Halloween episodes for both channels, this one and Event Horizon, link to that channel below. Halloween is my favorite holiday, and I've been busily filling my house with dried ears of corn and various carved gourds, as is the custom here. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.